Hello children, now again we are here to see our last part of our syllabus. We have to do some numerical. Before come to the numericals, we are going to see a special kind of PN junction diode, that is solar cell. We are going to learn here, that is solar cell. Now yesterday we have seen light emitting diode. Now today we are going to see the solar cell, photodiode and LEDs we have seen. Solar cell, my dear children, it is basically a solar energy converter. It is solar energy converter. So it is a PN junction device which converts solar energy into electrical energy. This converts solar energy into an electrical energy that we are going to see. Now a solar cell, we are going to draw a diagram here. See that here we are going to see a light radiation of suitable frequencies fall on this surface. Here is a top surface, that is of glass. Here you can see the metal finger electrodes, p-type metal finger electrodes are there. Metal finger electrodes, see this. Now below this we are having an n-type semiconductor. Here you can see a metal contact is there. Now we can say here is the positive side, here is the negative side. The solar cell consists of an silicon or gallium arsenide PN junction. It is made up of silicon or gallium arsenide PN junction diode packed in a can with a glass window on top. Here is the glass window, here you can see. The glass window is here and it is totally packed in a can. Is that clear? The upper layer is of p-type semiconductor here. The upper layer is in a p-type semiconductor, my dear children. It is very thin, so that the incident light photons may easily reach the PN junction. Here it is the photons are falling of energy greater than forbidden energy gap. On the top face of the P layer, here you can see the metal finger electrodes are prepared in order to have enough spacing between the fingers for the light to reach the PN junction through a P layer. PN junction pe kaise aa rahe? Through a P layer. It is coming like this here. When the photons of light, H nu is greater than Eg, fall at the junction, electron hole pairs are generated. Electron hole pair are generated at the PN junction layer. Or we can say at the deflection layer. Electron hole pair are generated at the deflection layer. near the junction, the electrons and holes produce move in an opposite direction. Electrons are going like this, holes are coming like this. So electrons and holes produce moves in opposite direction due to the junction field. Due to the junction field, the photo generated electrons moves towards N side of PN junction. The photo generated electrons move towards the N side of the PN junction, and the photo generated electrons moves towards the N side of the junction, and photo generated holes moves towards the P side of the junction. So this will connected at the two side of the junction, here and here, giving rise to a photovoltaic between the top and bottom metal electrodes. एक तरफ positive हो गया, एक तरफ negative हो गया. So we can see here the top metal contact acts as a positive electrode and bottom metal contact acts as a negative electrode. Here it is a positive electrode, here it is a negative metal electrode. We can see here this is positive and this is negative. This is called solar cell. So when an external load is connected across this metal electrode, what happened? Photocurrent flows. So we can write here, my dear children, you may write the important thing, that is, write down here. When an external field is connected here, positive and negative electrode, external load is connected. When an external field or load is connected, we can say here, across metal electrodes, a photocurrent flows. Okay, so this is a very important thing. Write down here, what are the uses of solar cells? They are used for charging storage batteries in daytime. Charging storage battery in a daytime, which can supply the power during night time. Din mein hum isko charge kar sakte hain during the sunlight, or we can use them during night hours. Okay, yes sir. Now what are the second use of this? The solar cells are also used in artificial satellite to operate the various electrical instrument kept inside the satellite. So they are also used in an artificial satellite. They are used for generating electrical energy. In cooking food, we are also using. Pumping water. They are also used in calculators. Wristwatch, light meters, photography, whatever. A lot of advantage of these solar cells are. Okay? Yes, sir. They are also used to produce electric power in remote areas. we can use this electric power in remote areas where the electricity is not available. So this is a very important advantage of solar cell. Where power from the electric is not available, they are used for power traffic signals also. A lot of uses of solar cells. Okay, now we are going to see some numericals of our NCERT textbook. Most of the part of this chapter is deleted. So here we are going to see, open your NCERT textbook and see the questions. Now, my dear children, open your NCERT textbook and see NCERT textbook at page number 510, question number 14.11. 14.11 of our chapter 14. Question number 11 we are going to do. So see that. Read the question carefully. A PN junction diode is fabricated from a semiconductor with a band gap. Band gap is given 2.8 electron volt. ऐसा PN junction diode जिसका band gap आपको दिया हुआ 2.8 electron volt, can it detect a wavelength of 6000 nm? This is our question. Read the question again. What is here? Here we are having the forbidden energy gap 2.8 electron volt. How much it is in joule? E is equal to 2.8 electron volt. If I multiply it by 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19, it comes out in joules. Write down. Solve this. 4.48 into 10 raised to power minus 19 joule. This is the band gap here. Wavelength given, that is lambda is equal to 6000 nanometer. That is 6000 into 10 raised to power minus 9 meter here. Now, our formula for the energy is E is equal to hc by lambda. Put all the values of hc and lambda. 6.6 into 10 raised to power minus 34, 3 into 10 raised to power 8 divided by lambda, 6000 into 10 raised to power minus 9. Now solve this simple mathematics. H is the Planck constant, C is the velocity of the light, and lambda is given. What you are getting here? Here it is equal to 3.31 into 10 raised to power minus 21. This is the energy here. We are getting here this much of joule. And here the value of Eg is this one, 4.48. into 10 raised to power minus 19 joule. Since the energy of the light photon is more than the band gap, energy of the light photon is more than the band gap जो आपको दिया हुआ है, तो it cannot be detected. So we can say it cannot be detected. Here, write the answer. Why it is so? Again, I am saying, the energy of the light photon is more than, yet is the more than the band gap. जो आपको band gap दिया है उससे ये energy ज्यादा है. So we can say here it cannot be detected. Is that clear? Write down. And then see the next question. Only 2 and 3 questions are there. Now see the next question, 14.12. Here the question in same page number 510. Read the question carefully. What is that? What are the things given here? The number of silicon atom per meter cube is, that is given here, N of E, that is equal to 5 into 10 raised to the power 20. Yes. The number of silicon atoms diya hua aapko. Here the number of silicon atoms. This is dumped simultaneously with 5 into 10 raised to the power 22 atoms per meter cube of arsenic. And 5 into 10 raised to the power 20 per meter cube atoms of indium. Here. Calculate the number of electrons and holes. Here we are going to find out. Given that the number of intrinsic charge carriers is 1.5 into 10 raised to the power 16. These are the things given. Then what we have to do? Again I am writing what are the things given here. The number of silicon atoms. This is dumped simultaneously with the 5 into 10 is about 22 of arsenic and 20 of indium. What is Ne? Write down here. 5 into 10 is about 22 of arsenic minus 5 into 10 is about 20 of indium here. What is there? 5 into 10 raised to the power 22 minus 0.05 into 10 raised to the power 22. इसको चेंज कर दिया मैंने. 100 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया, 100 से डिवाइड कर दिया. तो ये आ गया 4.95 into 10 raised to the power 22. Here, see this. This is per meter cube. Okay, how it comes? Multiply and divide by 100. This is there. NH is equal to NI square divided by NE. NI diya hua aapko. That is 1.5 into 10 is power 16 divided by NE. 4.95 into 10 is power 22. Here it is square. Yeah. This is our formula. So once you solve it, you will get it 4.55 into 10 raised to the power 9 per meter cube. See this, solve whether you are getting or not. Ne is greater than to that of NH. Here you can see Ne is greater than to that of NH. Here. So semiconductor is an N-type semiconductor. This semiconductor is an N-type semiconductor. This is the number of holes, that is this one, and number of electrons, that is 4.95 into 10 raised to the power 22 here. So this is very much greater than to that of this. So we can say here, when the number of electrons are very much greater than to that of number of holes, easily I can say this is a type of N-type semiconductors. Okay, write down. So this is there. Only 3 to 4 numericals are there in this chapter. So do this. Okay, bye.